begin our show by taking a look at a couple of trains from Thayer, Missouri. This train departing south to Memphis. Check out the last unit on this train, BNSF 1107, which has been partially repainted. We now fast forward a month into September as we catch BNSF 7700 departing south towards Memphis. Note too that BNSF 7700 also sports a three-chime air horn as opposed to the Nathan K5HL that are usually associated with these ES-44s. Check out the leader on this northbound freight. BNSF 784 still wears its war bonnet paint scheme. Locomotives such as this were delivered in the colors of their predecessors until a new paint scheme was created for the newly unified railroad, the only changes being the large BNSF added to the long hood. BNSF 5042 sitting on main one must wait until this northbound clears as the line goes back to single track just underneath the overpass. We jump ahead to October 29th, 2023, and we check out a UP freight heading towards the yard about 6 miles north of this location. This train has an SD40N leading, something you wouldn't typically see nowadays on mainline freights, as most of these units have been relegated to either local or yard service. I was sent to Sioux City as a bar out during this time frame, and the hotel room where I was staying at had a very nice view of the UP tracks. We jump ahead the next day and catch another UP freight heading towards the yard, this time with an SD70 Ace on the point. Next up, we catch the UP local, setting out some reefers and picking up a couple of cars at one of the many local trackside businesses on the line. After the crew drops off the reefers at the local business, it will back onto the line, couple onto the two reefers that it retrieved off the spur, and then recouple to its train and continue south towards Council Bluffs, Iowa. After the job is complete, the local departs south. Next up, we catch a Sperry rail detector car. This car checks for any defects in the rails to see if any repairs need to be made.
This is a trip to MRL country you won't soon forget. Join us now for MRL Montana Mainline Part 2. Helena to Sandpoint. Since October 9th.
Next up, we catch a pair of UPGP40Ns as they come to a stop on the main line. Older EMDs such as this were quite a common sight during my stay here. A day didn't pass where at least one of these didn't pass by my window. Just before dark on November 4th, 2023, a long UP freight passes by, heading towards the yard in Sioux City, Iowa. UP operates a handful of trains like this over the line each day. It's not uncommon for them to feature mid-train helpers. However, this one also featured a rear DPU. Thank you. According to some of the crews I've hauled in this area, some of these trains can reach upwards of 200 cars, not counting the locomotives. On November 6, 2023, we catch a UP local led by a pair of SD-40Ns. Interestingly enough, these units are leading long hood forward, not something you typically see on Union Pacific. This train also featured a few ex-Chicago Northwestern and Missouri Pacific hoppers as well. Later that same day, UPGP38N number 557 leads a long cut of cars back to the yard in Sioux City, Iowa. Next up, we catch the SD40Ns returning to the yard in Sioux City, Iowa. Once again, they're leaning long hood forward.
So,
Just before dark on November 6, we catch another northbound UP freight as it heads towards the yard in Sioux City. This train features three different EMDs in its consist, with an SD-70 ACE leading, an SD-70M as the fourth unit, and the trailing unit is another GP-40N.
Thank you.
Next up, we catch a pair of UPSD-70Ms leading a freight into the yard. The northbound train grinds to a halt and sits for a few minutes before once again departing north to the yard in Sioux City. The reason for this is unknown. The next day, we catch another UP local, once again headed by GP38N, 557. Later that same day, we catch another northbound local. Once again, with older EMDs in control as a pair of SD40Ns, take the train into the yard at Sioux City. We flash forward to November 9th, 2023, as we catch a southbound local, once again in control of older EMD power, this time a GP40N. As we've seen throughout this video, older EMD power was quite a common sight in this area.
Later that afternoon, we catch yet another northbound local freight, also in control of a GP38N and an SD40N. UP operates a handful of these locals each and every day to service many online customers along this route. Although this video features UP Freight, BNSF and Canadian National also service the Sioux City, Iowa area. Not too long afterwards, yet another northbound UP local passes by, this time with a GP40N leading, long hood forward. On November 10th, 2023, we catch a southbound UP freight with three AC4400s and an SD70M in charge. Thank you. Our last train of the program is another UP local with an SD40N and a GP40N leading long hood forward. This line featured a lot of action and a lot of interesting locomotives from UP's roster. Hopefully I'll get to come back someday and catch some more trains here. We hope you enjoyed the video of railroading action here in the Sioux City, Iowa area. And as always, thanks for watching.